So I know I said that I was gonna take a break, but I just had to come back to frickin' talk about this. So I'm sure a lot of you know, but in case you don't, Void Interactive no longer has a publisher. The name of that publisher was Team 17, and if you're unclear of what a publisher is or what it does, in exchange for money, the publisher will promote the game and give it a lot of advertising, along with helping create the game. Like, they'll send over developers from their company to help work on the game. I'm sure they also do a lot more, but that's basically the gist of what a publisher is supposed to do. It basically invests in the future of games to make more profit, pretty much, and Void just lost theirs. Now, we're not entirely sure when this happened or why. At first, when I heard about it, I wasn't entirely sure because when I was looking at their website, Ready or Not was actually still on Team 17's website, along with Team 17 still being on their Steam at the time, but I guess I was just looking at an archive. I don't even know if Steam had archives. But the one thing that did kind of throw me off is when they actually launched that tutorial video, and we didn't see a Team 17 logo at the very beginning or at the end. There I was kind of like, maybe. I actually reached out to Void Interactive to see if I could get an answer, and they just didn't want to talk about it. They just kind of ignored me and just answered other people's questions. Then I was kind of like, well, I think that if they were with Team 17, they would definitely say yes. What everybody's saying is preposterous. But just the fact that they didn't answer my question is just like, okay, so maybe there is some truth to this. Then the next day, Big Fry receives a message from one of his subscribers or something. They had asked Team 17 themselves if they were no longer with Void Interactive, and they just came out and said it. Hello, Team 17 Digital and Void Interactive have mutually agreed that Ready or Not will no longer be published by Team 17 Digital. Well, isn't that interesting? And then after that, the cat was out of the bag. Void Interactive drops a tweet just a couple of minutes after that. Void Interactive and Team 17 have mutually agreed that Team 17 will no longer publish Ready or Not. We are confident that this is the right path for the future of Ready or Not, and we thank Team 17 for their partnership and wish them great success with their spectrum of games. Somebody had asked if they were going to make a more comprehensive statement, including reasons and objectives for this move, and Void responded with, "Unfortunately, we cannot say much more about the split, but we are confident that this move will be the best for both parties and will allow us to continue to produce and update Ready or Not on Steam Early Access." So yeah, I do have a couple of theories as to why they might have split up, and this is just complete speculation, nothing is set in stone, but one theory that I had was that maybe Team 17 and Void Interactive had creative differences. They probably heard about the school shooting level and the human trafficking level and the drugs and the violence and thought, maybe this game's just a little too hardcore for us and maybe we should tone it down. But I kind of don't buy that theory because it's like, well, how do you go into a game and not know what they're trying to produce, right? Like, this is not a kiddie game. This is a game that deals with a lot of issues and is not trying to stray away from that. Like, I don't think they've ever hid that. So the idea that Team 17 didn't know what they were going into is kind of like, I don't think so. And also, they're supporting a game like Hell Let Loose. Hell Let Loose, the game where you can literally get turned into chunks, see torsos and arms everywhere on the floor, blood everywhere. Like, Ready or Not is tame compared to Hell Let Loose in a lot of ways. So I kind of didn't buy my own theory, and I am kind of getting ahead of myself. But my second theory, and I think is more likely, is that Void didn't hold up their end of the bargain. So Team 17 was promising Ron that they would help their development by sending out developers to them and funding their team, you know, making sure they have a paycheck every week, along with going with promotions and advertising, you know, the game and all that stuff, so long as Void releases when they said that they were supposed to release, which, if I'm not mistaken, the beta was supposed to launch sometime in June, July of 2021. Well, it's December and we're still in alpha, but it launched into early access, so I mean, they definitely missed that date and didn't hold their end of the deal. So why do I think that it's this and not the whole thing with creative freedom? Well, it's not the first time that Void was partnered with someone and then all of a sudden they just kind of left without saying anything. If anybody remembers Blacksite, these guys were helping them and then they just kind of, what's a good word, ghosted? Like before, when you saw something with Ready or Not, you'd also see the Blacksite logo, and now it's just kind of gone. Like, they stopped doing anything with them a little after the whole multiplayer event fiasco with all those content creators. Like, I don't mean to open old wounds, but that's kind of what it feels like. Again, this is all just speculation though. I could be completely wrong. Those were just two theories that I had at the time of hearing about them separating, but ultimately it's just not a big deal. I mean, really what I think about it is like, them not having a publisher allows for more creative freedom, but at the same time, having a publisher allows the game to keep going, keep it funded. Ready or Not right now on Steam is fucking killing it. I saw that they were like top 10 games being sold on Steam, but how long is that going to last? Like, I'm sure they're making like a shit ton of money right now, but is the product at the moment worth it? Well, I'm gonna have another video for that, hopefully sometime soon, so look out for that. I think I actually have an interesting take on it. But yeah, it's interesting to see how this studio is going to do without a publisher. I mean, I don't think that they need one because, you know, Ready or Not, I think, is unique enough to do pretty well on its own. But yeah. So now we're getting into the reason why I'm making this video. And that is because Kotaku put out an article. Game loses publisher day after devs remind fans about apparent school shooting level. So at first I had thought that they had actually, you know, confirmed what I was thinking the other day. But reading through it, this article just heavily implies that it's because of this mission that Team 17 split up with Void. But then later on in the article, it goes on to say, while unconfirmed, people online speculate it's because of the level's intended inclusion. So basically, this is a bogus article. You know, it's kind of funny because back in 2018, there was actually a meme about this on the Reddit. Somebody had actually predicted that it was freaking Kotaku that was going to be the one that talked first. We saw this back in 2017 when the trailer launched. This guy, the bounty hunter, freaking called it big lol. But basically, what I think this article is trying to do is bait Void Interactive. Because what it doesn't do is talk about the drugs, the racism, the human trafficking. No, that's all fine. But that school mission, it's just that school mission. We gotta protect the children. I mean, that Five Nights at Freddy's security breach is okay. You know, the one where they kill children and stuff them in suits. That's fine. God forbid they make a singular mission where you prevent a shooter from causing any more damage than he's already done. But I mean, the guys who made this article already knew that them talking about this mission was going to back them into a corner, because no matter what you say, the devs just aren't gonna look good talking about any mission that they're adding into this game. In my personal opinion, I think that they shouldn't have said anything. They should have just continued their work as if nothing happened and let the audience decide for themselves whether this was a good thing or a bad thing to add into the game. Because I think a lot of people probably would have been like, well, the Titanic happened and people made a movie about it. Well, 6 Days in Fallujah happened and now they're making a game about it. I don't think I need to talk about how many games there are of World War II and also movies of World War II. There are so many tragic events that have happened and eventually they just get turned into games or film. Like, the only thing that I can really see with this is like, is Void Interactive getting more profit? Because this almost seems like the GTA effect, when people were basically trying to create a controversy about GTA 5 and it ended up blowing up even more than it already was. But Void got baited and they ended up responding to it. Here's what it said. There is no easy way to address this issue without creating strong emotional responses from one group or another, but we will do our best. I would like to start by mentioning a quote from our original company documentation that we have always believed in, continue to believe in, and that has been known to anyone who has engaged in business with our company. This is what it says. Void Interactive has a clear commitment to deliver high quality, impactful content that other mainstream software developers may shy away from due to cultural conventions and norms. At Void Interactive, we value the voice of our customers and partners, and while this will not dictate our direction, we will allow it to smartly influence what we do. At its core, the game honors the work of dedicated law enforcement officers across the world, and in no way intends to glorify cowardly criminal acts. We are dedicated to promoting a level of authenticity and realism in our video game. Ready or not, that carries with a difficult subject matter. We understand that this requires a certain responsibility to our fans and community, yes, but also to those who have been impacted by traumatic events law enforcement all too often responds to. Rest assured, our aim is to handle all of Ready or Not's content with the level of weight and respect that it warrants. We have recently had to remind certain team members of the required care in discussing this material, now and on an ongoing basis. School is not just a part of the fabric of Ready or Not's story, it is a part of the fabric of thousands of people's stories worldwide. It is the story of those who have died too soon at the hands of a deranged gunman. The story of family and friends waiting for a phone call that might never come. The story of the first responders who do everything they can only for it to not be enough. It is a look at an uncomfortable reality that has become all too common, and we hope that we can play some small part in honoring those who have been impacted by these real-world tragedies with a portrayal that does not trivialize their experiences. We will continue to follow our vision, we will continue to listen, and we will continue to work every day on Ready or Not. Thank you. Sincerely, the Void Interactive team. So, I'm not gonna lie, this is a pretty good response, but they gave them what they wanted. They somewhat validated this article, and now they're gonna take this and use it as ammunition, most likely. So after this, 5 more of the same freaking articles pop up on a bunch of different websites with the same freaking lie. It's basically like a copy and paste job right here. And yeah, you kind of just gave them what they wanted. And in response to what these articles have been saying, the community manager at Void
Interactive had said this: the split between Team 17 and Void Interactive had nothing to do with the school level. So all of these articles are literally bogus. And the first one to come out with an article that actually admitted that was a different article. I think it was actually PC Gamer. Like, these are like the first ones to actually correct the record as far as I can tell. But yeah, I just wanted to really talk about this because it just felt like a bit of a hit job, even though we all know that there was nobody here that doesn't want to see that mission. Let's be honest here. The only people that might not want to see that mission are probably people that don't even play video games or have probably never followed this game or aren't into this type of game.
But either way, I guess we're just gonna have to see how Void handles it. You know, school shootings should be like a thing of fiction, but for some reason, they happen a lot in the US. Like, I think instead of blaming video games, they should fix the freaking problem instead of using, you know, these types of games as scapegoats. But that's all I really got to say about that. I hope you guys are having a good Christmas. I'm about to go open up some presents and yeah, more videos to come out for Ready or Not pretty soon here. I'm gonna do like a whole update video from everything that's happened between early access until about now, and I'm going to do a is the $120 worth it video remake, because I got a comment the other day asking if I could do one of those. I was like, yeah, sure, why not. And then we're gonna hop more into Project Zomboid because my freaking thing over here is filling up with so much goddamn footage of that. We've been playing it like crazy. And then also we have a bunch of games that I need to get through from other indie developers that have been asking me to cover their game. So yeah, I'm gonna end it here. If you enjoy the fact that I cover games like Ready or Not, then be sure to like the video, share the video, and comment down below. If you're someone that would like to support the channel, check out my Patreon or click on the join button that's underneath the video. If you're someone that's new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and ding that bell so that you can get more content on Ready or Not or any other game that I decide to cover. And with that all being said, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.